loving Hyrule Warriors. I think it's a really good, interesting game and a spin-off take from the franchise. I can just play this for hours and hours. It's not like anything's going to be distracting me. Oh, hello. Oh no, my castle's under attack. Ah, I hope my castle is okay. My castle is fine! What the hell is my Windows Phone on about? My castle is fine! This game is way too addicting. Well, I'm here. Play some FIFA 14. No one has bought my stuff.
It's a vlog.
Yeah, this totally makes me look like an assassin.
I'm so fancy. Yeah, I know.
I'll shut up now. Yeah, do you like the new look? Anyways, I'll mention about more about my new hoodie in a minute. Anyways, hi, I'm Steven Walker from CT Films. It's a vlog. So, what videos I did this past 1 week? The Forza Horizon 2 demo recently came up this past 1 week on Xbox Live on Xbox One, and I did some following gameplay of it. And surprisingly, it got almost nearly 1,000 odd views, despite though the base I did some lame rubbish driving, and then afterwards when I did some gameplay and played it fully, I did quite well afterwards, so I'm a bit regretful for that, so yeah. But overall, it was nice, however, to get that many views and nearly up to 1,000 views, which is brilliant. And also, this past 1 week that came out here in the UK and Europe, and that is in the good old Hyrule Warriors, and I've been playing a bit of that yesterday when it came out. And it was great, it's nice to get it, but the problem is, as I mentioned on the video, I had to get in a different place than it is than Tesco's, and it got me a bit stressed out a bit. I would have done some gameplay of the day one tile update, plus like that, and the DLC when you redeem your own code to Club Nintendo, your registration code to Club Nintendo, you get free DLC. I would have done some gameplay of that, but you need to unlock Ganon to be able to use that costume. And I'm like, god damn it, thanks Nintendo. So I could have done some extra videos on that, but instead though, I just did a particular Hyrule Warriors, and plus I was a bit stressed out on that day and I couldn't be bothered to do any other types of videos. Besides, I kind of did a video of the Smash Bros. And demo, the public demo that came out this past 1 week, even though the following week, you know, since the announcement that they were releasing some demo codes for Club Nintendo people, and I was not one of the lucky people that got it, and I didn't want to be greedy or asking for people for codes, because loads of people have been asking people for codes this past 1 week, and it's just stupid and pointless, really. I mentioned about it on my Tumblr and plus a Miiverse as well about that, and I got loads of stupid comments on that video, despite though it's got quite a decent amount of views, which I'm actually pleased of. But still, the stupid comments, however, like, oh, how do you get the demo? Because I got it since 9 a.m. at the UK time, and I posted my gameplay, and most people haven't got it in their regions, and people have been asking and all that, and just stupid pointless comments like that. I'll say, oh, do you have a code? I'm like, a code? It's now public on demo now and stuff like that. It's just annoying, however. And I mentioned about this on my Tumblr and plus my Miiverse and all that. It's just stupid. It's just overly hyped, this is. I'm guilty of that too. I'm really looking forward to Smash Bros. When it comes out in the next 2 odd weeks, which will be fun to be doozy. Also, I would have done some videos of iOS 8 that came out on the good old the good old iPod Touch that I got, but I would have done a video of it, but I didn't want to, because loads of people would be doing videos of iOS 8, let alone the iPhone 6 and iPhone 6 Plus that came out this past 1 week as well. Also, that I played recently on my Windows Phone and also Windows 8, and there's the new Age of Empire free-to-play game that I would have done some gameplay of also when I started playing it, but there was no point, however. But I will explain my thoughts about it, though. So those are the kind of videos I did this past 1 week. So yeah, after playing the Forza Horizon 2 demo and waiting for Hyrule Warriors to come out, in between that I've been playing the new Age of Empires own game, I can't pronounce it, it was Castle something, but whatever. It's basically a free-to-play game that's on Windows 8 and Windows Phone 8, and I decided to, I first started by playing it on my Windows Phone. I'm like, oh, this is a quite interesting game, because basically it's kind of like, I never actually played this, to be honest, on iOS or Android or anything like that, and there's Clans or Clashes, I forgot what it's called, but that popular type of game. I never actually play it, but the aspects of that sort of game kind of resemblance to Age of Empire. But however, it's just when I was playing it on my Windows phone, I was like, oh, this is quite good. And I thought, I wonder if it's one of those games where basically you play it on your Windows phone, you do it on Windows 8, and basically it kind of does sync up, but doesn't sync up most of your achievements that you unlock on your Windows phone to, you know, do it on your Windows 8. But however, it got a bit addicting a bit, because I was playing it on Windows phone, and then just playing on Windows 8, and it's just starting to get addicted to it. And also that it's got this thing where basically you can battle other opponents that have their own castles and whatnot. And basically, you can actually attack them. So, like, you got the... Because you have to gain resources, of course, like most games, like Simpsons Tap Out, where you get resources to be able to build things and set your stuff. Knowing free-to-play games like that. But when I was... attacking people on Windows 8, it's quite funny because I attack most people to have limited resources, the noobish people that play them on their phones, because you can tell if it's someone with a Windows phone because it says player and a bunch of numbers. That's how you can tell when it's a Windows phone player, because they don't have a proper like gamer tag or an Xbox Live account. That's how you can tell. And I was just picking off noobs just by those people that are on Windows phone. It's just dead funny that how only just limited resources and stuff, and just gain all their resources, like, come on back to the base, you know, and stuff. But overall it was quite addicting. I've been playing it one night when I had my sister over and she was playing on my Xbox, and I've just been playing that and building up my own castle and whatnot. It's quite an addicting game. If you do have a Windows phone or Windows 8 in general, in case you want a few extra achievements, I kind of recommend it. It's quite a fun game. Also than that, fun fact, and basically, I never actually played an Age of Empires game until I played that game. But I did, however, did get Age of Empires 3 when I got that for 10 Microsoft points at the time back in 2010. That was a really good offer, and I let my CEX friend play at the time before he was working in CEX at the time. He used to come round and basically he tended to play it a bit lots on my desktop. But it was nice having to get that for 10 off Microsoft points, and at least that was kind of worth it, even though that I never actually played much Age of Empires game. I have downloaded the Age of Empires Online when it used to be on Games for Windows, but I haven't played that much. I never got grass into it, and plus, you know, it's one of them free-to-play games as well. But that got shut down, the services, like, a year back or whatever, I can't remember. And then I just started playing the new Age of Empires game that came out this past one week called Windows Phone and Windows 8. Yeah. So, yes, I have got a new stylish type hoodie type thing. As you can see, it's quite nifty than other types of hoodies that I've worn in the past and all that. And it's quite nice, as long as you get it right, because every time you kind of sit down, it's just like, and ruins it. Ruins the whole look and stuff. But when you stand up, it's quite nifty. But overall, my friend kind of got me this, because I had my friend over that I don't usually see as much as my CEX friend. And I'll explain all that, because I had a day with them both this past 1 week, which I'll mention about in a minute. And he bought this hoodie online and basically got it from one of those like Chinese things where basically you can order from a Chinese person or something like that. Sorry, I'm not being racist, alright. But basically places like China and stuff like that, and basically you can get them quite cheap before they sell them off like 30 to £40 sort of thing. And basically got the wrong size up, because he's a bit larger and stuff. No offense if he was watching this, but it's just he got like a different size, and in China it's kind of a different size in their region and stuff. Like, say if it was an extra large, it was actually a large type thing, and all that. So he ordered it online, and it didn't quite fit him. So he just gave it to me, and it's, and I'm just like, oh, thanks for the late birthday present. Because, yeah, and I just said it was a late birthday present. But, yeah, it's quite nice, however. It's like one of those things, if you ever see them ads on Facebook or anything ad-wise, it's kind of the similar hoodies that you usually see, but they're not quite as stylish as you would thought, because they all usually advertise these as like, oh, Assassin's Creed replica type, you know, things and stuff like that. And it's just funny, however, that my friend got one and it did not fit him, and he just gave it to me. It's nice, however, this hoodie is. I'm going to start maybe wearing this, even though I usually wear my leather hoodie type thing I usually wear when it's a bit rainy. Well, it's going to get a bit more rain now, since it's kind of autumn and stuff, but yeah. Yeah, it's just nice how this hoodie is. So guys, what I've been up to, I've been to InTraining this past 1 week because I had an appointment with my advisor, and basically I thought it was actually this Tuesday, and I was going to do the Forza Horizon 2 demo before I go to see my advisor, and surprisingly the demo didn't came out until, you know, 2 in the afternoon, and surprisingly I got the dates one. It was actually on Monday, so I went in to see my advisor on Monday. And basically, we had a bit of a discussion, and like I said in previous vlogs, basically she wanted me to do an analyst, and it was my second analyst that I did for analysing for what hours that I needed to do and stuff. And surprisingly, even though I mentioned a few vlogs back, I was going to do 30 hours, even with the 3 hours work that I do in Lincoln's Community Trust, basically, and also the needs I have. And basically, we did a second analyst, and it turns out I was better off doing 20-odd hours. I'm like, thanks, I guess. So she kind of put me on job seekings now, which kind of disappointed me a bit. And then my mum started texting me saying, oh, nothing's going to change, something's going to change and stuff. Don't worry, Stephen, because I get paranoid quite easily and stuff with things that change and stuff, because I'm quite difficult when it comes to change. And overall, I did the job seeking thing and this Thursday, because I went in this Thursday to do it, and I applied some things, basically applied for some jobs, and basically I thought the closest to my heart and suitable was basically Lincoln Community Trust, even though I work there every Wednesday for 3 hours and stuff like that. I just thought it would be suiting, and plus it would just get that done. And I had to go in, and I only had to go in every 2 weeks until something happens. I do not know if I'll end up getting a job. I do not know stuff like that, but I just don't know. It's all BS in the end, and I should not be talking about this because it does upset various people on the internet, even though that most of them are kind of still young and don't know the symptoms that I have and whatnot. That's the internet for you. Thanks, internet. But still, however, you know, I've just been going through that BS lately. But however, after when I had my appointment with my advisor on that following Monday, basically I had my CEX friend day, which was quite a nice surprise. And basically we just chilled and chat and stuff, and calmed me down a bit from all that. And then surprisingly, because I don't usually invite people and go on Facebook and say, hey guys, come to my place because I need some living. Not like that, I'm not gay. You know, but basically I'm a bit nervous when it comes to asking people first, so, you know, I'm like that with most people on Facebook and stuff like that. But it's just, my CEX friend invited my friend over, and we had a right good laugh, and we just watching my CEX friend play Destiny. And my CEX friend has been playing Destiny loads and loads. He's such a hypocrite, though, because when I first got access to the bay, he's like, hey, I'm going to get access to the beta. Do you want to play on it? It's like, no, I don't particularly like that game. It's Halo. And there's too many, you know, Halo games. And Microsoft are too busy sucking the life out of Halo, like Nintendo does and stuff like that. I'm like, okay, fair enough. And then when I first got the beta, and it came round one time, I was like, oh yeah, I'll just play the beta, see what it's like. Yeah, it's not so bad, I guess. And then a few weeks later until I got the actual game when it came out, and then when I got the game and when it came round that following day, and I let him play it, and then it was like 6.5 hours later. He's been playing it and basically gone more than I did, because like I said on the last vlog, I didn't scratch most of the surface on the moon level. And he actually completed the moon level and he's on Venus or something, I can't remember. But it's just funny, however, that he's played it more than me and spent then 6.5 hours later type thing on Destiny. But however, you know, it's just nice, however, to let him play it, because I do let my friends play my new games, because one time he's like, oh, look, I get to play games for free and stuff, let alone he borrows games from work and CEX and stuff. But overall, it was a nice night to have my friends over and all that, and my CEX friend came over a few times this past 1 week, and plus knowing out my sister and whatnot. Speaking about my sister, it was last week, however. It was my sister's birthday last week, and basically, and she got some monies, and basically she asked me to get something on Amazon, so she got an Amazon gift card, and she knows that I order stuff from Amazon, and basically she got an Amazon gift card, and she told me to order this, which came in the post today, which is good, so I can actually show you it off, and basically I got this, which is a Sims 4 mouse. Now this mouse is mainly for my sister, of course. And basically, my local shops don't have this, even though a particular store might have had it, but they didn't have any. So I had to order it online for her. So I'm a good big brother, I am. So I ordered this online for her, and basically, it's the mouse that she wanted. So I would have done an unboxing of this, but I don't think it would be worth it, though. And most of you viewers, I know some people I know who play Sims 4, but it's just... not just a pointless unboxing, so no point. So my sister will be pleased with this, and plus it's nice and sealed. I'd rather keep it sealed, even though I did say to her, oh, can I do an unboxing? It's like, yeah, sure, you can do an unboxing, because she knows me quite well. But on that though, just been fine and dandy. Just been a bit stressed with most things, like say for example the Hyrule Warriors type thing. I didn't get the right price that I wanted and stuff, and most of it was towards Smash Bros, but I'll live in the end. I'm sure I got one of the money that I recently saved up towards Forza Horizon 2 and Smash Bros. But yeah. So anyways, what videos I'll be doing next week? I'm not entirely sure what videos I'll be doing next week, but the week after that, I'll be doing some various videos like Forza Horizon 2 and Smash Bros. And maybe a particular something if all goes to plan. Ooh. But that's not next week, but it's the week after. I just don't know what videos to do next week, but yeah. I love making videos for you guys. Anyways, so that's my vlog for you guys. Hope you will enjoy it. Do not forget to follow me on Facebook and Twitter. And hope you guys have a really nice rest of your weekend and stuff like that. Anyways, I'm about to go now. See you from Stegy Films.